This video shows some basic shapes we can create using shells. The first one is a torus, for which we need to use the revolved geometry method. We space-click a circle for the profile polygon, draw a vertical revolution axis some distance away from it, and set 360 degrees for the revolution angle. Then in 3D, we can use the free rotate command to rotate it into an upright position. The next shape is a hyperboloid. For this, we will use the ruled geometry method with the detailed construction method. Both profile polygons of the ruled shell are circles. We space-click the drawn circle for the first profile polygon. Specify the distance between the two profile planes, then space-click the circle again for the second profile polygon. In 3D, this now looks like a cylinder. We will now rotate the upper profile in its own plane around its own center point. Let's specify 120 degrees for rotation angle. The result is the hyperboloid we aimed to achieve. The last shape is a wedge shape. Its base is a square and its top is a slanted surface. We will use the ruled geometry method to do this. We define the first profile polygon, set the distance between profile planes, and then define the second profile polygon. We defined the slanted size for this second profile polygon, as we will rotate its plane later. In 3D, we turn the plane of the upper profile polygon by 45 degrees. This way we achieve the result we wanted. This wedge shape could also be achieved by creating a vertical extruded shell and defining a wedge-shaped contour polygon for it in a section or elevation viewpoint.